For two centuries, the Shauna Corporation has used borrowed futuristic technologies to provide Traveller, Python, CG, Skyrim, and bikini videos for the subscribers of this YouTube station.
Please do look around. Just be sure to subscribe.
I wanted to give you this, a token of my appreciation.
So I installed a remastered director's cut version of Danica. She's in here somewhere.
Skyrim certainly has its fair share of it.
Guess I'm just being silly.
Trip the Rift Mater.
I think you should continue with your performances.
What's the point?
It's only for the same few people every night. Oh. A lot of mods done by Tripped Rift have disappeared from the Nexus.
Shame if you stopped.
I hate Freckles.
All right, Wilhelm. The mods, the least I can do for you.
The mods are questionable. They're borderline. I'm not going to say the word, but there's some people out there that get enraged when they see Trip the Rift mods on Nexus.
I really hate necromancers.
In the past, the outfits for some of the kids have been questionable.
I'm never really afraid.
Depends.
Adult-themed outfits for children, that kind of thing. And Trip the Rift is like, right. What? What about it?
You would say so.
And so Trip the Rift has taken their mods, most of them, off the Nexus and posts them on Tumblr. So Tumblr kind of is a clue. Something's gone off the rails. When you're posting pictures on Tumblr, it's not necessarily pictures of, you know, scenic views. Or maybe it is. But anyway.
Stupid dog.
So this director's cut was put on Tumblr. So I was kind of wondering, what am I going to run into here?
Stupid dog.
But the Tumblr page for Trip the Rift is lately, it's nothing but, from what I can see, it's nothing but child followers with huge ass tits. So imagine, you know, 8 or 9 year old kids with tits, huge tits. That's where Trip the Rift is right now, in their head. So yeah, it makes sense that the mods are posted on Tumblr now instead of on Nexus.
I heard Temba yelling at you yesterday. Why do you let her treat you?
But, you know, Trip the Rift has this huge-ass lore-ish friendly backstory as to why the characters exist.
I'll head back home if you need me.
There's much more to worry about in life than a bit of temper.
Yes? Have you heard of the Blessing of Dibella? It can help you with the wooing of women, if that's your aim. Go away. So I wouldn't have to answer stupid questions from idiots. Now, if you'll excuse me. Well, if you say so, not my problem. I don't have to take that from you. Hope you're willing to back those words up with your fists.
So anyway, she's
nice
one of the guards
me
at Iverstead.
My appearance. I'll let you live this time. No, now shove off. By the gods, I don't even know what to say. It's like the ancient legends. Dragonborn.
Now, I don't know how far you have to be in the Dragonborn questline for her to believe you or not.
I think you played beautifully. It would be a shame if you stopped.
I mean, I did talk to the Greybeards, so that's probably proof enough that I'm Dragonborn.
Friends like you are hard to find. And very valuable to me.
I like her outfit, though. It's kind of cool.
Lead the way.
Reminds me of Oblivion.
I'm right behind you.
Once she's a follower, then she's basically, you know,
of course,
a vanilla character that just follows
what do you
around.
Want me to carry?
Now she will summon a Valkyrie-type character who looks very anime, fairy-like, who will defend, come to her defense. I don't know if I've seen that helmet before.
You lead, I'll follow.
Have you spoken to Fastred yet?
No. I'll tell you, Wilhelm. If I could sweep her away from here tomorrow, I'd do it. But Klimek still has so much to learn.
Hello, my friend. What can I do for you on such a fine day?
You should follow your
Have yourself a great day.
Perhaps one day.
This is a nice place, don't you think so?
Yeah, so I sent Lydia home, but I think we beat her home. Because I remember showing up at Bree's home and she wasn't there.
Divine smile on you, friend. I can teach you a few things. Right then.
Or in agreement with what do you think?
So I'm back to my standard race template where health, magicka, stamina, it all starts at 100. The only thing race related that I have modded, I think, are the heights. I'm using the Morrowind heights for my races. That's it. I noticed yesterday the guy that does Wildcat and Sacrosanct and Winter Sun and Andromeda, they came out with a mod that overhauls the Magicka in the game. I was like, wow, this person's put a lot of effort into recalibrating, balancing all the Skyrim enchantments, the magics, the just about anything you touch in the game now has been revamped. But it's just too much. You got religion thrown in there too much to keep track of. All the gods. And it all has to work together. Then you got Imperius on top of that. I like Imperius, but unfortunately, it makes custom races. I don't like having custom races in my game, because then you have to patch pretty much the whole game to make it work with your custom race.
All right then.
Same goes for.
I'm right behind you.
The modder's growl, which overhauls the werewolf stuff. That one has a custom race too.